Hello everyone, and welcome to the Bedok Reservoir Park. It is Wednesday, the 25th of August. It's 20 past 5 p.m. and the temperature is 28 degrees. The plan today is to walk around Bedok Reservoir. So there is a walking path along all of this area, and this is a converted former sand quarry that collects the runoff water from eastern parts of Singapore, and it's an area that people come to do water sports in. So you can see people kayaking in there at the moment. And the trail is supposed to be nearly 5 kilometers. It's 4.7 or so. And we'll try to go around today. The weather has cleared up. We've had a lot of rain, very heavy rain, over the past couple of days. The sign over there is about, other side is for people who want to fish, and there's no fishing on the other side here that we're going to, the right side. So yeah, the rain for the past couple of days has been so bad that pictures of a flooded shopping center were going around in the social media. Flooded streets. It's not very uncommon for that to happen in Singapore. Or sudden flooding. Okay, so straight away there is an obstacle. I know it says part of the jogging trail is not in use, so let's have a look. Entry path. Okay, so back there, I guess. Yep. Someone else has to do the same thing. Yeah, so the heavy rains meant that it wasn't so nice to come to a place like this, but today it's cleared up from early rain. If you watched my earlier video in Angmokyo, I am in fact back from there. I didn't get lost forever. And it's not so surprising we have another diversion, I guess. An interesting structure. I don't know what the function of that is. I think there is a pass around here. There's a children's playground. As you can probably hear, but yeah, since last video, I think diversions are becoming my thing now. Seem to be very good at finding them and not so good at finding my way back. This is maybe not as scenic as I hoped the start would be, but there are some HDB buildings going up, I think. I guess Temasek Polytechnic must have like a sports complex. That looks almost like, what is that? Tennis? Football? See some green. They definitely have a stand for people to watch. Might be a I think it's combined. Like a running track. A running track with a field in the middle. That would be one of the campuses around Singapore behind there. Feel a little bad for all the runners. Guess there are plenty of them. Not just because they're running, of course, that's good, but the scenes are not so nice on the other side. If you come here thinking you're going to be by the waterside, then that's not it. That's going to be the water venture outlet. Okay. So these are some of the water sports facilities. So we must be close to being able to get back to the quarry site. Singapore Institute of Technology says on that building. That's a big campus. There's another like a mud track kind of thing there. I'm tempted. So I can see someone jogging over there, yeah. Footpath ahead. Let's see. So this is not the official route, but we made it to the other side. So these people are all getting into their kayaks, ready to go out on the water. And look at this. So much better than the first few moments. Thanks for sticking by. So that's the horse adventure over there, but it looks pretty closed. It has all kinds of like bridges and things. I think you can do that gliding thing where you go like a distance. I don't know what you call that. A vague idea, but you probably get it better from the picture. But that does look pretty coast right now. Guess you could walk up there as well. Here's the thing where you can go over the water, hanging from the lines. This one's pretty high. So that's definitely closed for now. I don't know if it's open on weekends or not at all at the moment. That's where you would go. I guess the sand over there is where you're supposed to land. The sun is going to be kind of facing me for a little bit. Have a look back there. Oh, there we go. It's actually really nice considering it was raining this morning. Currently in the eastern part of Singapore. Just north of Bedok New Town. I guess that's where you could cross over to that campus, over that little bridge. This would probably be quite a nice area to have your lunch break or do exercise. I wouldn't say during lunch, it could be quite hot. Most days, maybe after lectures. Sorry, just adjusting. So no swimming and no entering of the water and no release of animals. Noticed my rising speed off. Let's see if I can fix that a little bit. Sorry about that. It's just really annoying to look at. Probably for you too. At least you got a nice view, maybe a little bit shaky. Off the water side. So there's actually a good reason, especially here, for saying no to swimming and release of animals as well. And that has to do with an incident they had over here some years back, where a student from that polytechnic over there was kayaking here and he fell into the water. Nothing horrible about that. He did get to the shore. That's all okay. Didn't have a problem with that. But as he was in the water, he said he felt like some kind of fish was nibbling on his feet. There's a water ball field while we're here. But anyway, it felt like some fish were sort of attacking his feet. And as he got up onto the shore, it seemed that was exactly what happened. He had big wounds on his feet. And the expert said they were consistent with that kind of attack from fish. But there shouldn't be anything like that here. Or in this area. So they didn't really, I guess, do so much about it. I think there are someone's garden plots over there as well. That's really cool, city farming. But yeah, the incidents kept happening until they were able to catch the fish. And they did confirm that there were species of fish here that are not native here, not native to Singapore. And someone must have released them. So that fish attack took place in September 2014. So a while back. But I think everyone who goes on water here was told about it and aware of it. that's also a rumor that this place is haunted. Don't know what's that, what that's based on. Looks pretty calm to me, but I guess you never know. And you are allowed not to wear your mask if you're exercising, by the way. Or continues that way as well. So there's quite a bit of green area to exercise in, have a walk. I see a lot of people coming in even by motorbikes and cars, just like I did. I rode here on my motorbike and there was free parking just outside. It's quite windy, so apologies if the mic is picking that up. I do have a new system now where I'm able to adjust the level that this quite sensitive microphone picks up. I guess I could check how that's going. It's a sort of test. Look really weird with my gimbal and iPhone, and then my other one recording the sound. Looks okay even with the wind. But there is a lot of wind now. before with the noise from the street, that kind of thing. The volume from the mic would go so high up that the audio was just kind of stop and crack and sound very bad. Have to see how this is. But having the app and the second iPhone recording this certainly makes it easier to control. That's a bit of tech speak, but I feel like that's as good a topic as any, considering that you'd think when you have your equipment all set up, the stabilizer, the gimbal, and your phone for the camera, and you have a microphone, you just kind of go and walk, right? But there's a lot of tech involved, and even at the point of uploading videos to YouTube, I had no idea it would take 2 or 3 days to get these online. So you might see me publishing things out of order. It's not that when I put the first one in, it's the first one out as well, but I think that's fine. You'll see it when it's done. There's some big construction going on over there that I'm not sure what it is, but I see people going past it without going around it. So that's more promising than the last one, I guess. We'll find out in a moment. So my plan today was to do this walk and head over to another town, a part of town, where there's a football match today. And they're finally allowing, I think, 1,000 people in. So I'm hoping to be one of those. I also had the idea of doing a walk around that area. But I left just a little bit late. So we'll see how that goes. Also had to do that detour. But if not today, then another day. So that's the look back to where we're going once we make the loop at this end, getting to the furthest point from where I left. And you can see the puddles around here. All around the grass is also really, really, really wet. That's from the rains. I think they said that we got in like 3 hours as much water as you normally get in a month. I don't know if you can see, but the ground is completely waterlogged. I wonder if that's some kind of fishery. I don't know. I'll have to check. This whole area only was converted in the 1980s. And I think it's been sort of growing ever since. Whatever they're building. Oh, wow. I was wrong. I think they're solar panels. So, yeah, I think they're putting in solar panels. Seems like a good idea in a country like Singapore. There's an ad on YouTube where it starts. I don't know what it's for. I don't know what that is in. It is, but okay, they say no filming off that side, so I'll just point my camera away. But in any case, the ad says something like, we all have 7 hours. No, we all have 12 hours of sunlight. Makes more sense. if you live anywhere like I've lived, you don't kind of get that. You don't have that at all. So it's kind of a very Singaporean thing to do and say. Okay, which is coming out of the area that says no filming. This is just 10 concepts village, so we can look at that. They're building a really nice looking building there. And caves with rooftop barbecue, they say. All right. And we're back. We're going to have a 3-story indoor water adventure here. Sounds good. They definitely have some pet parrots flying around. Don't know if you can see that. It's against the sun, so I don't think it's possible to catch that on camera now. So that's the part that we've already been to. There you go, probably a glimpse of those.
Oh my god! Oh my god.
So they're just flying around and getting very close to people. There you go. Interesting. So that walk is also accessible to people. But it's not very long. It's really warm to be running here. But a lot of people are. So good job. I don't know. These ones are over there. But something's going on. So as part of doing all of this and developing this area as a park, they brought something like 14,000 plants here as well. So that's the whole area. You can walk on the water with some benches as well. And there on that side is the road. So we're never far from that. And on the other side is the building project we had to walk around beginning of this video. Parks have been open all through COVID, mostly. At some point they closed the parking and you were only supposed to go to the nearest park. But I think, yeah, and at some point you couldn't go with anyone who wasn't the same household as well. But we never went into sort of a kind of lockdown where we couldn't go out at all. I still, right now you're not allowed to have huge crowds or anything. Keep trying to see if those are birds or bats on the surface of the water. I think they could be birds at this time. But when it gets the sunset, bats come out. Thank you. see a lot of people out. The weather has definitely improved. And it's not just entirely sunny. So that's a good combination. A bit cloudy after the rain. This morning it was 26 degrees. That tends to happen when it rains. Then it gets back. So we're getting to opposite to that building site. And only a little stretch to go before we're back where we started. So we're never far from the traffic, but it is pretty quiet here. I think I'm only about 10 minutes late from my original plan right now. This is also a really popular spot for watching the sunset. But we won't do that today. Do that some other day. Yes, right now it's 6:15. We've been going for around 57 minutes with the detour. That's not too bad. I'll see if I edit some of that part where I wasn't able to film out of the video. But as we get back to where we started, thank you for joining me for today's hopefully relaxing walk around Bedok Reservoir. If you would like to join me for future walks here and elsewhere in Singapore, you can subscribe to this channel and then you'll know when I post new videos. I try to go out and walk every day as much as possible. And if you have a place you'd like to see the walking video from in Singapore, leave me a comment and I'll try to do it if feasible. There are a few things with this channel that I can only do once someone or enough people are watching these videos. So it also helps a lot with that if you like them and if you subscribe. So nice that you were able to join. I hope you enjoyed the walk and I'll keep the camera rolling for a little bit until I get to the parking lot, but thank you for watching. And I hope to see you again soon.